So propriety and all, everything is something which is only something we discuss. It actually doesn't exist in their dictionary at all.
No, but
they just do things for money and nothing else.
No, I think while that is an absolute fact, the fact is also this matter is coming out in the public domain. Many of our viewers are asking that Times Now is putting out so much material in the public domain, what's going to happen to it? Well, let me take one example before I move on to our next report. Last evening, here on the News Hour, we had revealed the confession of underworld don Dawood Ibrahim's brother Iqbal Kaskar. You would remember that. He had told the Mumbai police in 2003 that the IPL bookies were involved in fixing even then. Today, the Times Now exclusive report was used as evidence in the Delhi High Court in the spot fixing trial. What Ashok Pandit, let me ask you as a cricket lover before I go back to London, to Mehir Bose. What if the BCCI argues technically legally? You know, what I'm hearing is they'll argue very technically legally. They'll say, no, there's no direct evidence. There is no, you know, absolutely certain line. And for all that the media may be saying, we don't need to answer to anything unless it is 100% techno-legally valid. Will they get away with that is my question to you, in your view.
Arnab, I think the BCCI is waiting for you to have a one-to-one interview with Dawood, and Dawood himself saying that I am involved in IPL and my money is there and I am controlling the entire IPL. The BCCI is waiting for that one-to-one of your interview with him, because they are used to these kind of interviews now and these kind of exposures now. It is a matter of shame that how many examples has to be quoted, how many proofs have to be given, how many incidences have to be brought to the public, to the nation, to prove that IPL is nothing but a vulgar display of money, IPL is nothing but a vulgar display of arrogance, IPL is nothing but a vulgar display of the underworld don's involvement in this, IPL is nothing but it's a vulgar display of indiscipline and arrogance in the name of cricket. The opening scene of IPL is where the players are bought, they are auctioned. The entire field of buying out players is based on a wrong premise. This is not sport. Your entire clothes have symbols of your sponsors. Initially, there used to be the Indian national flag. You say that you play for the country, but it is not playing for the country. It is a sham and it is nothing else but a vulgar display
the problem is that some people, I'm not going to target only Kishore Bhimani again, some people, Mehir Bose, have felt that we, those who question whether IPL is following the rules and the ethics and the morality of cricket, are all old-fashioned people, that, you know, those who expect this to be cricket don't know anything. So, for example, Mr. Mehir Bose, let me point this out. In 2011 February, this gentleman Guru Nath, who we are now talking about, Srinivasan's son-in-law, he gives an interview in which he talks about how he and Stephen Fleming and Dhoni exchange our 11s at 5:45 p.m. for the night matches. In other words, talking about how franchise owners have the power to select the cricketers. So franchise owners have the power to select the cricketers. Yeah. No, and by that logic, they are privy to crucial team information and the decision-making process. So today, today when this is happening...
Arnab, can I come in here?
Yeah.
Hello, can I come in?
Yeah.
Arnab, can I come in?
Yeah.
What I'm saying is, this, what is happening to Indian cricket is exactly similar to what happened to international cycling. There, we found that the Cycling Federation were not capable of exposing Lance Armstrong taking drugs.
Ah.
So what happened? The police had to come in. The United States agencies had to come in. And what this shows is that the cricket organization, an autonomous cricket organization, while it may claim all sorts of things, it is not capable of policing itself. So the judicial authorities have to come in. The outside bodies have to come in. Remember, Lance Armstrong for years claimed he had never taken drugs. He was exposed by the United States authorities because they finally found the proof. And the same thing has to happen in Indian cricket. The outside bodies have to come in who have the legal powers, and they have to investigate properly and come up with the truth to make cricket clean and also to make us restore our confidence.
Which outside agencies?
The cricket body is not capable of it.
Which outside agencies? The Central Bureau of Investigation? Bureau of Investigation?
Absolutely. The government must appoint a commission.
The compromised Bureau of Investigation, which says that Pawan Kumar Bansal need not be questioned. Which investigative agency? You know, the problem in our country is we've created such institutions. It's difficult to have faith on any.
But in that case, the whole country is corrupt. There's nothing you can do.
But the
point is, there must be possible to appoint a judicial commission. Remember, the South Africans appointed a judge to look at Hansie Cronje. Can be done.
Whenever yes, you can't commit that's
something,
right.
You committee it. That's the thing which we do. Absolutely. You can't commit, committee it. What nonsense. Absolutely. And Arnab, I wanted to make another point about, you know, Ashwini made a point about I have a strong law. This country has more laws than anybody else can remember.
I agree.
It is their implementation which actually sucks. And the other thing is, you know, very often when you strengthen a law, it is actually misused by the powerful people to harass people. Then what happens is the protection mafia comes in. When Haryana had prohibition, you know, the people who didn't want the prohibition laws to be lifted, the politicians and the police, because that way they can protect people like who like to drink, so that they can, you know, start a protection mafia. If you are drinking, you have to pay me. They make money through that also. They only end up strengthening these people.
I also question the logic of the esteemed Delhi police commissioner. I mean, I don't understand how good a policeman he is. I have my doubts. I've always had my doubts on Mr. Niraj Kumar's empathy ever since he refused to come back in some other cases. He's very happy to face the media. Mr. Delhi Police Commissioner, I have a question for you. How on earth, Mr. Niraj Kumar, could you say on the 16th of May that no other players or owners are involved? I mean, it's ridiculous. I want Mr. Niraj Kumar to see this today and ask himself, what is his investigating ability? The Delhi Police Commissioner says on the 16th of May that as far as we are concerned, no other players or owners are involved. Latika Khaneja, tell me candidly, does that also not seem strange to you? We've been asking how only three...
Definitely.
Yeah?
In view of whatever has been coming out, definitely that could... And to make a premature statement is also... When something has happened, there has to be links across the board.
If somebody is starting such a huge investigation, where there are 700 phone calls, transcripts, etc., have you ever heard of a case, Latika,
all of them are.
Huh, Lashwini?
That goes to show how compromised all of them are, because it's been run by such powerful people. So, and they're all, you know, benefiting from it.
So I'm going to ask that. See, when the BCCI is asked questions after the India TV sting, they say it's loose talk. When the Delhi police begins exposing it, immediately the same day says nobody else is involved. And today, I'm sorry to say this, the Chennai Super Kings, what do you call it, principal, Mr. Gurunath, is hiding. He should be explaining whether he had those phone calls. So, you know, it's not going to stop here. But I want to go back once again to David Callaghan. Dave, what about the credibility factor, Dave?
Yeah, Nikki, I think from my side and listening to the debate, I think one of the concerns is, I think there was an earlier gentleman that mentioned Lance Armstrong's story, and I think and then there was a further gentleman that mentioned with regard to generalizing with all this with all other players. And I think from our side in South Africa, I know that there are a lot of players in this country that would die to play in the IPL, obviously to make the money and to be and create exposure for themselves. So I think the gentleman that mentioned early on with regard to Lance Armstrong's story and the fact that they had to get independent people to come and sort out the problem, I think that's very true. I think that's probably what will eventually happen in India, to sort cricket out, because at the moment you've got a wonderful product which has been destroyed off the field by all the allegations about match fixing and about parties and all that type of thing. And just from my side, from the party side, party and celebrating a win after the game has always been is been part of the game. And obviously, to that extent, not really. And you know what the players do, if they are doing that, then obviously that sort of culture is going to go back and also damage your own image and your own players.
Is the IPL going to be the same after this, Kishore Bimani? Last word to you, sir.
May I just two small points out? One is why the BCCI seems to be above the law. Is it is protected by politicians, the only sporting body that is protected by politicians from across the board, from the so-called ruling party to the so-called opposition. Secondly, there's only, we've all discussed what is the answer. A judicial probe is the only answer, but will that judicial probe, which will say X, Y, and Z are wrong, that Mr. Srinivasan is wrong for wearing so many hats, that there are certain people in who are committing conflict of interest. When that comes out, who is going to enforce it? The government? What is the government? The government same people who run the IPL.
I think the political parties...
Rajiv Shukla is told that you have to do this.
No, but I think political parties... Mayor Bose...
So as a result,
I agree with you, but Mayor Bose, last question to you, it's an important point. You know, I think this... Okay, we lost the... Point here is, I think political parties will have to take a position. It's too convenient. I think biggest political parties of India who are represented in indirect ways by big political players on the BCCI will have to tell the people of India where they stand. Let's see if we can take that forward tomorrow.
Not in the election year.
Well, I don't know. I think it's important enough in the election year.
Credibility.
Well, it's a question of credibility, agreed.
Point about credibility.
Absolutely.
You know, this credibility, do you realize yesterday...
Yes.
You know, yesterday when Sahara pulled out and issued a statement on why it did so, you read that statement, at the end of it, you are looking at a company called Sahara, which is embroiled in so much controversy itself, and you look at what it tells BCCI, the Board of Control for Cricket in India, and you actually tend to believe what Sahara says more than BCCI. That tells you completely about what the credibility of BCCI is currently.
Well, absolutely. Well, we have much more details coming on. I'd like to tell our viewers once again, as they would notice, this channel is deeply investigating the story. We will continue to do so regardless of who tries to advise us. Thank you very much for joining us on this NewsHour debate. Gentlemen, ladies and gentlemen, thank you.